Right here.
I tell people this story, they don't believe me, but God has a sense of humor with me, because the day that the Grammy nominations came out, my nephew was born. So when people were calling me up to say congratulations, I was going, yes, he's 7 pounds, 3 ounces. He's so beautiful. And they were like, you know, no, we're talking about the Grammys. So for me, my life is so hectic. And then I never really, maybe 10, 15 years from now, I'll be able to sit down and be like, oh my God. Come on, baby, light my fire. When I was young, it could all be so simple, but you'd rather make it hard. Loving you is like a battle, and we both end up with scars.
You've been quoted frequently about your views on the lack of opportunities for women in the music industry. What do you think we can do to change that in the future?
I think it is changing. I hope that it's not a trend. You know what I mean? I hope it's not like disco music, and then a couple of years later it'll be out of style and no women will be able to do what they're doing. It's a challenge, just because for some reason people always think that behind some woman there's some male toy master or manipulator who's telling her what to say and what to think. And also, women aren't supposed to know what's best for them, you know. But adversity doesn't scare me. If the group has broken up, I don't know about it yet. So maybe somebody should call me and let me know. But I don't want to think that, you know what I mean? Because I think that as a collective unit, you know, there was a lot of strength there. But we've always been a strong unit, and we've also been strong individual personalities. And I would hope.
I turn the last to the first, make the God respect the earth, and I change the murder rate to the birth. Y'all understand what I'm saying? You understand what I'm saying?
Check it out.
Hold on.
The city, you know what? Hold on. Y'all know what the city want to see, right? They want to open up to Channel 7 News and said the Fugees had hood shock and a bunch of black and Latino people had a riot on the house.
But we're not going to do that.
We ain't going to do that.
Because we know better than that. Because we're not animals. We civilized.
You're bugging the fuck out.
What?
Hey, bro, you're bugging out.
What she was in?
Take a fan.
She gonna catch hell. She gonna catch hell.
Nobody.
I don't really think anything happened. I think that nothing has really changed for us. I mean, I think it's great that the people, you know, acknowledge what we do. That's a beautiful feeling. But
I mean, but we basically can't go Hollywood though. You know, it's like we can't forget the reality. Once we forget the reality, the message becomes synthetic.
Oh, la, la, la. Yeah. It's the way that we rock when we're doing our thing. Oh, la, la, la. Uh-huh. It's the natural, not only Fugees can bring. Oh, la, 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 la. So we came.
My whole motivation is to basically bring musicality back to the ghetto, back to the hood, to bring the lyricism and just the spirituality in those songs. Like Bob Marley really meant something real strong when he sang No Woman, No Cry. And Roberta Flack was really talking about somebody affecting her in a deep way when she talked about Killing Me Softly. So we just try to use those metaphors in a hip hop format to bring it to the kids, you know, and let them know that, you know, we're spiritual people and we're musical people, and that, you know, not everything is about taking off your clothes and, you know what I'm saying, and violence and stuff.
It's important we feel, you know, that the whole world and the whole grasp the message.
On time, yeah. Turn your lights down low, yeah. And pull your window curtain.
It's incredible. You know what? People would always ask me, who would you love to do a collaboration with? And
I'm Swag Cranky!
Picked that song because of the bass line, and because we don't need no more trouble. There's so many things happening in the world today, you know, without sadness and sobbing around, and you know.
Turn Bob up a little more.
My music is completely about that. Is always has always been and always will be about really trying to expose the world, and especially the young world, to everything and every experience that I get to, that God has blessed me with having. And I just appreciate the fact that there's a company who doesn't ignore the community and the young people. And it's not just about, you know, how much wealth they can obtain, but also how they can make the playing field more fair. So I'm you all. Thank you. My mother, you know, for I think 20 some odd years worked in the North Board of Education. And you know, it's not necessarily that you don't have the potential, you know, you just need, you know, you need the technology, you need the people who can provide the teaching and the information so that these kids can learn and just be as balanced and as, you know, and as ready to go whoop the world as anybody.
No matter how you always see, but let me know the big ain't working. It ain't working. It ain't working. When I try to walk away, you gotta
just
let me stay.
Hey, yeah.
Let me stay.
Hey, yeah.
Let me stay.
Hey, yeah.
with this album, I wasn't looking for perfection, you know what I mean? I was looking for feeling. I wasn't looking for everything to sound its best. I mean, there are lots of vocal performances where I'm not singing as well as I know I can, but there was a vibe on that particular track that you just couldn't let go, you know, just a feeling. So that was my whole approach to this album.
Bob speaks to me in a weird way through music.
Believe it or not, his music shaped R&B music at that time and made it what it was, you know.
I remember when we used to say,
where
at? Oh, in a project yard in Brooklyn.
I think that we love the song, you know what I mean? I think that that's... is doing music and feeling the vibe and recreating a new vibe that young people right now can relate to.
But if you go for, you know, kids or people to buy your records.
Get your gun to meet me in the back,
right? We want to make sure we do the right thing, because like a lot of kids are dying or getting killed or being misguided because of the hip hop. They're not listening to the teachers, to the parents, they listen to the hip hop. So it's like, we feel like we definitely have to represent. I mean, it's like you have 11 million people listening to you. You want to say something worthwhile, you know? Because, like I said, you know, you at the end of the day, when the higher force come, you're going to be judged.
Everyone wants to be a cowboy. Grab your gun, boys. Ole he. 45 by my side, do he live? Do. You shot your bullet, but the bullet went.
Lauryn, right here, please.
Lauryn, right in the middle.
Lauryn, you rock. Lauryn, right here, Lauryn.
Lauryn, right in the middle, Lauryn. Come on,
Lauryn, rock.
On behalf of Levi Strauss and Company, thank you, Lauryn, for standing up in support of today's youth and tomorrow's leaders.
Well, Refugee Project is all about nonprofit, you know, setting up community service events, institutions. We've done a bunch of different things. We've sent kids to camp for a couple summers now, and it's really cool because these are kids who don't really get to, you know, get out too much from, you know, the bricks and the concrete of
amazing. I think a lot of times artists have to compromise themselves, as she just said. They have to put on the tight dress, like I do, and you gotta kind of sell that type of image. But she's lucky to be herself. She can wear her hair the way she wants to. She can dress the way she wants to. She can sing about what she wants to. And that's what the new millennium is about. It's about being yourself and not performing. So I totally am very inspired by her.
I want to hear this.
Yeah.
Going raw, imagine law with no undercovers. Just a thought for the mind. I take a glimpse into time, watch the blimp read the world is mine.
If I rule the world,
imagine that.
I free all my sons. I love them, baby. Black diamonds and pearls.
Could it be, if you could be mine, we both shine.
If I rule the world,
still living for today, in these last days.
My name is Nasir, and I cut it short to Nas, and a friend of mine pointed it out, my name out in the Quran, the Holy Quran. And I said, whoa, you know what I mean? And I figured, yo, this is all meant to be. This music I'm making is sending messages out, is powerful music. And I look at myself as one of the powerful voices out there. And it all makes sense. It was written sort of like a prophecy type of thing.
Come on. paradise life relaxing. Black, Latino, and Anglo-Saxon. I'm on the exchange, the range, cast. Lost tribe of Shabazz, free at last. Brand new whips to crash, then we laugh in the illopath.
Every rap artist that writes about his life experiences, mainly about the blacks in America, you know, it's something new to everybody. And the way you can put it in words, you can work wonders with the wordplay. So there's a lot of different MCs out there that make records and talk about the street life. What I do is talk about things that happened to me, things I saw, that I saw in my life. I always... Lauryn is crazy cool. She's like coolest person. I mean, I called her up because I thought it would be a good idea to have her sing If I Rule the World, which was originally, the chorus was written by Curtis Blow, but I just took it into my own perspective with the lyrics. But it was like, yo, for Lauryn, she's real talented, you know, a lot, you know, she's real respected in the hip hop community, you know, so I called her and for her to respond, so, you know, ready, it made me happy, yo, and just it just worked out for the best.
If I ruled the world and everything in it, sky's the limit. I push a Q45 infinite. It wouldn't be no such thing as jealousies or B felony. Strictly living longevity to the destiny I thought I'd never see, but reality struck. Better find out before your time's out. What the?
I ruled the world.
Imagine that.
It was either do this or become a victim to the ghetto. And as typical as it sounds, it's very real. You know, a lot of friends of mine didn't make it to see where I'm at. Not because of because of being bad individuals, just because of generations of just harsh life in ghettos and us not knowing where the light is so we can see the light and make moves. But my mom, cut it short, my mom's just happy because I chose the right path, I stuck with something, I focused on something that was real.
Women has played a major role in life overall. Me as a man, I honor that in itself. It ain't got nothing to do with the music. You know what I mean? So as a man, I'm here to salute women, period.
And we trying to build this foundation, this women hip hop foundation. So we have to lay the bricks to the foundation. If we kill everybody and hurt each other, we'll never build anything.
I think women, and in this year in particular, have done so many different things and they've broken so many different barriers that this would be an irreplaceable moment. You know, I don't think you could go back or go forward and try to relive this particular time when you have people like Lauryn and all these different artists that are out right now that are really positive in what they do and very good at their craft.
It is needed. It is needed. Men have had their for eons. It's our time now. It's our time. Let us shine.
I think a good lady of soul should possess confidence. She should be definitely, you know, on her game. You know, she's got to be well crafted and disciplined and humble. Thank you for your support in allowing me to pursue a career in this crazy business. I love you too! Woo!
tie you up in my shoes, make you feel pretty too. I was told I was beautiful, but what does that mean to you? Look into the mirror, who's inside there? The one with the long hair.
So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the 1999 recipients of Aretha Franklin Award, TLC.
We've been blessed in a lot of ways. Yeah, people always talk about all the things we've been through. May it be good, may it be bad, but we are strong, independent women. And we have stuck together, and we have three, okay. We have three wonderful mothers to thank for that as well, Gail, Ava, and Wanda.
Feels good. Lady of Soul?
Wow, I don't
want to. Yeah, yeah. Have to deal with two times tonight.
Good.
All right, cool. Back.
There's not a lot that people don't know about Natalie Cole after all this time, and the fact that she's still loved, that people still think I'm the bomb, that's a great thing, because I think it's a testament, first of all, of people who really want to know the real person behind all the music and all the stardom and all that stuff. And I've made it very, very plain that I'm not afraid of who I am and everything I've been through, and the fact that I could still inspire is a good thing.